4 months later. Yeah, it's November now. We're the spring semester people. We have a couple topics we're going to go over. You want to speak about adjusting real quick? What it's like to adjust to?
So, adjusting to life in Siena when you get there. It's definitely a culture shock. You live with a family. Family does not speak English like you're used to.
Well, some of them do. Yours do a little bit. Mine, Gina's much better Italian than I am. And she got the family that spoke a little bit of English, and I got the family that spoke none. So like, and what I'd recommend is Google Translate for a while.
That helped me out. I do not recommend it. You just have to expose yourself as much as possible. Speak as much as you can, whenever you can. Outside of class, try to speak. Instead of going into stores and restaurants and ordering in English, try ordering in Italian. Doesn't matter if you know not an ounce of Italian, just trying and doing your best.
The people like appreciate that, I think, just an attempt at it. And everyone we ran into in Siena was super nice and like accommodating. It's just a small city and everyone feels like they know each other, and it's just a cool place to be for the next couple of months. You guys are going to be a part of the winter semester, I'm guessing, based on when we're making this video. And when I planned on going to Italy, I was like, oh sweet, I'll be able to escape the winter time here in New York because it sucks here. And it's not as cold, but it's still like a lot colder than I thought.
We also took a tour around all of Siena, and it would have been way more fun if it wasn't so cold. It was really, really cold.
It's really cold.
Yeah, and like my house didn't have heat very much, so a lot of the times I'd just be like
wearing a parka and a bed because...
But that was like the biggest thing for me. I just hate being cold, so...
Be aware of that.
Yeah, so definitely invest in some warm clothes. Sorry not seeing this video like 5 days ago. You could pack a little more.
They're printed. Time to pack.
If you're like you packed like I did. There's like no clothes. So that's the weather. It will get nice in the spring. So look forward to that. Things to do around Siena?
Places to go out. A lot of students in our group went to Bella Vista.
The mojito bar. Yeah.
It's just like a small bar. It's pretty fun.
Are you recording?
Yeah.
Dancing.
Yeah, it's probably the most like lively place in Siena. Wait, there's another like Irish pub.
Yeah, the Irish pub.
Right above there. That's cool. I'd recommend that.
It's like right off the campo.
A lot of good restaurants. There's some bad ones. I just like stay away from any. A rule of thumb I had, if they have pictures of the food or someone's like trying to invite you into the restaurant, that's
don't
like
go.
Don't go. That's like my kind of red flag for those kind of restaurants. Try like as many hole-in-the-wall places you can find. Just explore the city. Gelato. If you see gelato that's like piled up super high and like looks really like visual, that's the worst kind. Yeah. Don't. It looks the most inviting, but it sucks. You want like flat, like muted colors. Is what I learned about gelato. What's the place called that's really good? It's not open until March for you guys, unfortunately. You have to wait on that.
What is it called?
This is the best gelato place in all of Siena. Don't fall for any other place. Something with an F. It's right near the Duomo. I'm also the wine guy. He's like this little old man.
The wine guy?
Yeah.
He's on the hill.
Yep, on the big hill on the way down. Wine on tap. super nice. Also doesn't speak any English, but you'll like learn little words to order. It's like $3.50 for
a liter of wine.
Yeah.
It's great.
We were there. They have like a little basement where you can hang out. Your phone doesn't work, so it's fun to just hang out with people in your group and like really take advantage of that restaurant they have.
The lunch restaurant.
Yeah, the little lunch restaurant. That place they had, like, that's some of the best pizza I had, honestly.
Yeah, that was great.
They're super nice there. If like they like you, they'll give you free drinks with lunch, which is super cool.
They'll give you like a glass of wine.
Mm-hmm. Or like some shots and stuff. Like,
that's fun.
Just pick the guy's brain about his alcohol display. Traveling, that's like the biggest thing I thought. We didn't actually end up going to any other countries. I had like these grand plans to go all over the place. And then like the places I wanted to go were just too like specific and weird. You know what I mean? Like the rock climbing places I tried to go to.
You want to go places and explore them and understand the culture there. And a lot of times in 2 days you can't even have that much time.
Exactly. A lot of people end up like Bus to Alps is a good program to utilize if you want to just kind of bucket list check places around. But it is kind of just like seeing Europe's greatest hits, and like I'm not really a city person. So I didn't want to go to like all the major cities, and I've been to Europe before, so what I did when I was there was try to find like really interesting places that aren't well toured or well visited. And you just get more experiences out of them. I'm going to cut to some clips of like me and Mario. We went on this hike to find this climb in the like right next to the ocean.
This exposure is fucking wild.
I know!
Awesome. And my phone died and we couldn't get back to the hotel. We got lost and we were walking through the middle of the night in this... We ended up getting picked up by a fisherman that drove us back to town, and then we had to take like a bus. You run into like adventures like that, which are super fun and memorable. The Dolomites are super cool. I'd recommend going there.
In your start, be his pleasure. Boom, shape, pleasure.
Today, Mario and I are in a town called Val de Funes.
What is it?
Val de Funes?
Val de Funes.
And we are going to try to hike those mountains in the distance over there. We're going to try to go up to those peaks. You can only go around behind them, so it's kind of a long walk. It should be about like 6 hours today. We're going to rent some snowshoes and maybe some cross-country skis. Should be pretty interesting.
Alright, so this town, it's technically in Italy, but it's pretty much Austria. Everyone here pretty much speaks German, doesn't really speak a lot of Italian. The U's and stuff have those two dots on top of them, all the letters here look weird. So Kyle and I have found ourselves in a town where not only do we not speak one language, but we pretty much don't speak two of the dominant languages spoken here. So it's been just a little bit difficult, but you know.
Alright, so we were right
here. We want to take the 5 to the 35, right?
We're right here where the little green eye was. Okay, actually, we're probably like right around here. And now we gotta go. So we gotta go straight for
the. Oh, we gotta take the 6 and then. The 6 meets up with the 35.
So it goes 6:35. Now, what did I say? 5:35?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so we're gonna follow the 6 and then hopefully somehow end up in.
Okay, cool.
Landlord, what's up, door is door. There's no more one standing at my door.
sunny skies, just me, my hazy eyes, I've done it too, once with you, but where is my demise, I've seen.
How are you feeling, Kyle?
I'm pretty tired.
We are almost there, kind of. Can't see it right now.
Hiding beneath the water, and I've seen the future, but I cannot seem to wonder.
What are you doing, Kyle?
Resting. We're about, what do you think, like 4 hours in, 5 hours in?
Yeah, just about.
I've seen the future, but I cannot seem to wonder.
Almost there. We had a wonderful view of all these peaks right here. We've been hiking for about, I'd say, 6 hours now. We're getting pretty hungry and thirsty. We made it to the top finally. It was about 6 hours. We started from down in that valley over there. Walked along this ridge. We finally made it up here. These are all the Dolomites. Some of the most beautiful things I've ever seen.
Definitely recommend traveling Italy before you begin exploring other countries. There's so much to see. Every place that you go in Italy is completely different. Every culture is different.
Like between the north and the south. Like we went to Sicily down in San Vito da Capo to go climbing. And it's like the people are so different, and they've never seen Americans before. They were so excited to see us. And up in the north, we'll go. We went on a ski trip with the whole group. We'll touch on that in a second. But where we were up there is like a German-speaking area. So there's like it's this kind of weird territory where there's in-between languages. Obviously visit all the major cities. Florence is cool to go out and like. Hopefully, you'll have other people studying abroad. We had a good friend.
Florence is very fun to go out on weekends and party. Yeah.
There's just like a lot, it's more of like a lively area, so I recommend going there for sure. They're going to want us to touch on the classes too. What do you think about the classes when we were there?
Do your best to pay attention in class.
The initial Italian, for me, I just don't pick up on languages. Like, she became totally fluent, and I was like way too reliant on her the entire time. Don't fall into that. You want to like learn on your own. The teachers are great. Antonella is one of my favorites. Very accommodating. She understands where we're coming from, I'm sure. I was my biggest thing. I wasn't even going to go to Italy just because I was nervous about the language barrier. And like, I'm never going to learn. I'm not going to pass the classes. But the teachers are very accommodating, and they will help you get to where you need to be. I got to be able to talk to my family a little bit, but initially it was like dinners were like awkward and tough. I was going to talk a little bit.
They would invite me over for dinner because Kyle wasn't able to speak to his host family, so I would be the translator. So I'd go over for dinner.
I'm a bad example, guys.
Once a week.
Everyone else did like pretty well, and it's not that it was my fault. I just didn't. I don't think we should throw the party. They want to see the good stuff. I learned a decent amount of time while I was there, and I was able to get by. The trip to Alps.
Super fun.
We'll be right back.
fun. Packed on a bus from SIS, Janka and Mike and everyone.
Oh, I forgot about Janka. Hey, Janka. Shit. I'm sorry.
And we just kind of headed out to Torino.
I don't remember what it's called. I have it starred on my maps. I'll show the
Altoa DJ.
Yeah, Altoa DJ, yeah. So there's like great food up there. We had like awesome wines, like $3 a liter. We had like just a great ski trip.
We were able to ski.
It's like I've never been on a ski mountain that like is so far above the tree line, so we'll cut to a bunch of clips of those that I filmed.
Temptation when you get the vibration. Won't do you no good. It won't do you no good. And you better start running when you hear the man calling. It won't do you no good. It won't do you no good. No, you don't mind. If you don't mind.
It's just like open and just tons of snow. It's awesome. It's super cool. And yeah, that was a great time. They really did a good job planning that. Thanks a lot, Mike.
And you guys will get to experience whatever trip they decide to bring you guys on.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if it's the same, but
I'm sure it'll be good. Mike's killer
awesome.
Planning stuff. Yeah, like every weekend you'll have something to do that's like interesting, unique. I don't know. It was just an all-around very good experience. Do you want to talk about Sissy for a second?
Sicily was definitely my favorite place to visit.
If you want to go somewhere warm.
It was February, it was 70 degrees out.
Mm-hmm.
We were able to wear tank tops. We ended up climbing right over the ocean, which was great.
Yeah, it was awesome right over the Mediterranean.
We rented a house, each of us paid $7 a day.
Yeah, the house is huge because it's like an off-season down there and you can get just awesome deals. The trickiest thing was the rental car.
We did some illegal things.
Yeah, we did. So, how many people went? We had like seven people and a rental car that seated like four. The car's just smaller there. And it was like this weird like hybrid between like manual and automatic, and like someone who doesn't drive manual, it was like really tough. We almost got into a couple accidents, and we put our friend Mario in the trunk.
Of the car.
Yeah.
It was very unsafe. And he would drive in the trunk of the car the entire weekend.
Yeah, it was not good.
And we would drive for
plan
hours.
Accordingly. We didn't think, we thought the hotel was closer and the house was closer and everything was like scattered about. It's just hard to get around places like that.
But definitely an experience that was awesome.
I'd definitely head down there. It's like 8 a.m. here right now. We are in Sicily for our first free weekend. I'm just walking around exploring our little complex where we're staying. So we got here around, I'd say like 4 o'clock yesterday. It's pretty hard to get around Sicily, just because all the mountainous terrain and there's a really poor bus system. So we had to rent a car, and Booking.com promised me an Audi. They gave me something else.
Used to ride Impala, turn it to a Benz. Niggas used to hate me, turn it to my friends. You should see how people treat you when that money coming in. Bad bitches calling cause I'm balling. And these niggas hating on me cause they starving in a parking. That's the mountains where they walking. These niggas ain't important, they informants really talking when them people get.
So today we are heading. Over those mountains right there. Basically, there. 30 minutes that way. 30 minutes that way, there's world-class climbing in a town called San Vito de Copo. Before we get started, I'll show you guys where we're living. This entire place right here, that's our house. It was only $13 a person per night. I don't know why. I don't know what's wrong with this town, this little like compound we're in, but it's so cheap. This would be impossible to find in America. But I don't know, it worked out for us. Good morning.
Good morning. Ciao.
This is my room. Shoshana's room. Pretty nice bathroom. Rosie's room. And Tana's. Got a balcony too. More views of the mountains and the rest of the little town. And the ocean's right over there. Right here. Hey. That's the house pet. He came last night and he hasn't left.
Hey, buddy. This dog just kind of came wandering out in the middle of the street and, no idea where, does he have a collar on?
We gave him some water. It is a monster of a dog. You guys ready to go? Yes. This is our new addition. That's Nick.
Yo.
Genius from high school. Rosie, she's on the abroad trip. She's standing right up the stairs. We got Tana. You guys know Mario. Walking along a little trail looking for the climb right now. There's the crew. I think we're gonna be somewhere along these cliffs right here. There's Gina. It's gonna be kind of hard to find since there's not like a way to pinpoint exactly which rock we're gonna be on, but we're gonna have a really cool view of all of this. What we're gonna see when we're up there. This is cave vlog part one. Currently hanging out up here, I'll show you guys the view. This is all of Sicily right here. Hanging out, waiting for the rest of our friends to climb up. They're climbing right there. Just snapping pictures of them. This is a cave vlog part two. I think I'm in a bird's nest. Based on all the poop everywhere. And all the birds that flew out of here when I came into this. But I have a really good view. The mountains and the water. And our friends that are climbing up. So I'm gonna be able to snap pictures from this angle and get this whole view in. And keep working your way left, you're fine. Yep, keep working your way left, looking good. We got you, don't worry, let go. And stick your legs out like an L. And Mari's gonna lower you down slow. Yeah, there you go.
Ready?
Nice.
And bring you down now. Make sure your legs are pushed out like you're.
Where am I going, Ethan?
Going up.
Just up.
Good job, Rosie.
I know.
You look like you're a very strong climber with your back.
If you want to just go to like the beach or get warm for a little bit,
yeah,
definitely recommend that. Obviously hit the major cities. Rome's great, tons of great restaurants. I mean, you have to see the Colosseum. Like, did you go to Italy? Didn't see the Colosseum? You know what I mean? Yeah, I think that's all I have to say.
Yeah.
overall, you guys have a great next couple of months. Just create your own memories and do your own thing. I know, like,
do something different. Don't
exactly. Don't do what everyone else is doing. Like, you'll see all your. I'm sure you had other friends that studied abroad that hit all the major cities and stuff. And just like explore new places that are just not that well traveled. It just gives you a unique experience. That's like my biggest piece of advice I can give you. Yeah, but thanks, guys.
Bye.
We miss you. We miss Mike and John and Antonella. Jules. Yeah.
And
I mean, all the teachers are awesome. Everyone's cool. Everyone's great. Should be like our end thing. Like, thanks, SIS. Wanna do that?
I don't want to.
Thanks, SIS. It's a good finish.
That's it. Say you never let me go. Deep in my bones, I can feel you. Take me back to a time only we knew how to wait. We could waste a night with an old film, smoke a little weed on the couch in the back room, how to wait.